Hey everyone, it's JFO. Welcome to Tuesday. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm an intuitive astrologer and I'm also a fitness coach. And today is actually the day of fitness. We're gonna really talk about personal development on Tuesdays. But if you would love to learn more about your chart and get a reading from me, look below for the link. But also, if you wanna join my team, if you wanna get fit with me, if you have a weight loss goal, I can absolutely support you and help you with that. I've lost 30 pounds in the last 3 years and kept it off. And I'm on target to lose more to get to my goal weight this year. So I am definitely someone who can mentor you and coach you and support you, but you could also do this with me. You can go on your own health and fitness journey with me and actually be a coach on my team. So if you're interested in that, then you're gonna wanna email me, email below, so that we can connect and see if it's a fit for you. So let's get started. So today we're going to talk about this very subtle mindset shift that will change everything for you in your journey with your body. Now, some people hate working out, right? And some people hate like food prep and all those kinds of like, oh, they're so healthy. Oh, JFO, it's so nerdy and healthy. I love it. I'm like a geek now. I never was before. I made it a habit and now I love it, right? But I wanted to talk about something that my trainer in my workout today was talking about, and she was saying that you think fitness is a physical result. Yeah, you're gonna get a physical result, but fitness is not about the physical. It's about the mental stamina. Think about it. When you're in a workout, it's your mind telling you, "Nah, I don't want to do this anymore." It's your mind telling you, "I don't want to show up tomorrow and press play." It's your mind telling you, "This hurts. I'm done." Right? Or it's your mind saying, "This feels so good, I'm gonna do another one," right? Or it's your mind saying, I can do it, right? So it's your mind controlling your body. When you really think about it, it's all the mind, okay? And that has never been more clear in, you know, looking back on my three-year journey of my fitness experience, because I was never a fit person, ever. I was not consistent with it. Maybe I went to some yoga classes, maybe I went to the gym a couple times, but I was not into fitness at all. Now, another thing I want to say is that we actually, my company that I work with, we have a mindfulness eating program, right? And so a lot of people actually need that type of nutrition because, again, it's not about the food. It's about your mind. So I wanted to give you this subtle tweak that's going to make you see your body, your health journey, and literally any goal you have in a whole new way. Are you ready? So you can say, you can wake up in the morning and you can say, "I have to work out, this sucks." Or you can say, "I have to food prep this Sunday, this sucks." Or you can say, "I have to go grocery shopping. Ugh, this is so annoying," right? Or you can say, "I get to work out today. I get to go grocery shopping. I get to food prep." Think about the shift of that. There are so many people in this world right now that can't work out. They're injured. They can't work out. There's so many people in this world right now that can't go grocery shopping. They don't have enough money to go grocery shopping. There's people in this world that can't food prep because they're homeless, okay? So you get to do these things, right? And by saying it that way, immediately when you say it that way, what shifts for you is you start to think of inspired actions you can take around it. So for example, oh, because I get to do it, well, maybe I do want to wake up a little extra, like extra early to have more time, you know, and meditate before I do my workout, whatever, right? Another really amazing shift that is like life-changing is when you're eating. See, here's the thing. A diet mentality, the only reason why diets don't work is because of the mentality behind them, right? It's this idea that I can't have that. Ugh, I can't have that, right? And the minute you get trapped in this idea that you can't have something, I have never deprived myself. Now, could I be at my goal weight if I had like fully deprived myself and was like an A+ strict macro balance portion control person? For sure, right? But I wanna live my life and I wanna enjoy myself. And there's some days I'm not gonna have weight loss days because I really am such a foodie and I'm not going to deprive myself. But when you say the word "I'm depriving myself," even that alone is very, very, very negative, right? So instead of saying, like thinking the thought, "Ugh, I can't have the chips tonight because I have to have this ridiculous salad that I don't want to have." First of all, you should make your own homemade potato chips, have space for them, and make a freaking amazing salad that you can't wait to eat. But I digress. instead of saying, I have to eat the salad, oh my God, I have to portion out my food, this sucks, I can't have the cake that I wanna eat tonight, I always wanna eat cake. No, what you're gonna say instead is you're gonna say, because when you're coming from that space, what you're really saying is, I hate my body, and so I'm forcing myself to eat less, right? Because think about it, if anyone is on a diet, you're doing it because you want your body to be different. Okay, so what you're doing is you're literally saying, I hate my body, so I'm forcing myself to eat the salad. Instead of saying, I love my body and I love feeling good in my body. And because I love my body and I love feeling good in my body, I'm going to eat this gorgeous salad and I'm gonna fill up on veggies because I feel amazing when I do that, right? It's a subtle, subtle shift. So, if you want more of this type of support, please contact me. I'm gonna have more like forms and things for you to fill out in the future. But for right now, you can just email me. I'm so available to support you because right now my team is small. So email me and also make sure to follow me on Instagram at callmejfo. Make sure to subscribe here on YouTube and I'll catch you tomorrow for our Love Vibes video. See you then.